How that does it work? Basically, it's a simple method of SEMRO represents its members by virtue of the deed of assignment that has been signed. By signing the deed of assignment, you're basically saying, SEMRO, I'm a composer of a song, or I'm an author of a song, or I'm a publisher of a song. Can you kindly administer my performance rights? Baba, different types of rights. There's within the copyright, there's different types of rights. We normally call it a pie chart of the copyright. So Tina will only administer the performance rights within the pie chart, and also administer the little time rights of that. And I'll come back to that just now. What would happen is SEMRO will go out there, license each and every music user. Ukuthi uzosebenzisa music we ama member wethu, and 90% of people who are in South Africa are SEMRO members. I'm saying 90% because there are still people ukuthi music wabo has been exploited, but they're not SEMRO members for different reasons. So it's not ukuthi mhlambe ucabanga ukuthi enhlakaniphile or like that. Some of the lack of knowing ukuthi when do I go to SEMRO? Why must I go to SEMRO? Ngenzani SEMRO? But at least that's the reason why it's gone on the plan. Then after negotiating our license fees throughout the music users, Lavasemzu Music, then they will pay a license to SEMRO. The fees differ. It's anything from 100,000, some of them even less than that, because some of the community stations, they also pay less. I'm at restaurants, if you find it's a restaurant, it only caters for 50 people. License fee are going to pay is quite minimal. But its license fee gets paid annually. After it gets paid, SEMRO takes that money and invests. Then we go back to the music users, for example, the radio station. We say to them, submit what you call program returns. Program returns contains information if and which song was played, who is the composer, who is the author, who is the publisher, who is the artist, how many times was played, from which radio station was it played. Then we take that information, we put it on our system, and then we match it according to the pool that we have in terms of distributable royalties. When I say distributable royalties, I mean, if, for an example, I'll just make an example, this doesn't mean which is what is happening with that registration. For example, Gagasi FM will pay Asiti, and again, I repeat, it's an example. Gagasi FM pays 50,000 annually. From that 50,000, we took that 50,000, we put it in what we call a pool for Gagasi FM. Then we have Mthambi Metro FM. Then we have Mthambi YFM. All those different radio stations or TV stations, they will have their own pool. Now, what we will say, we would come to distribution time, we will go back within the pool and start asking and answering questions. For example, then go as a part of a pool layer in terms of music played. How many songs are there? In terms of who are the rights owners, that means who is the composer, who is the author, who is the publisher. Is there an artist? Yes, there's an artist, but is the artist as well the composer, or the artist again? If the artist is not a composer, then he or she will not receive performance royalties from SEMRO as such. The people who will receive our royalties now is the composers, authors, and publishers. So basically what will happen is, must establish it again, which okay, there's X amount of songs within the pool. We invest that with the amount distributable in the pool. Because sometimes there's undistributable royalties within the pool, and normally that comes back to one. Ingoma, Igwe, Eriku radio station, but the person who is the composer of the song, either he or she is not a SEMRO member, or they haven't notified the song to SEMRO, i.e. they haven't said, SEMRO, here is my song. Wololo is my song, I am the composer of the music, or I am the composer of the lyrics, or I am the publisher. If we find such things, we don't distribute those royalties. However, it is SEMRO's duty to go back to either the radio station or to go back to the co-composers of the people I want to listen to, or to go back to the record company, or to go back to the publishing company and say, we've got this money, and that's what we call it undocumented royalties. We go back and say, we've got this undoc, we believe this is your song as XYZ. If you say it is yours, then you notify them, then we pay those royalties out. Now, as we pay those out, we would now not pay them as radio royalties, we pay them as what we call post-distribution, because it means the royalties for the radio distribution has already ran for that distribution, for that period. Now, what we will do is, because we already ran that, but we still have the money, somebody has came and claimed, they provided proof that they are the composers, then we will pay those royalties out. When does SEMRO pay our royalties? SEMRO is 18 months behind in terms of calculating royalties. And when I say 18 months, what do I mean? Whatever that we pay in Konamanje in 2016, it is the songs that have been exploited from July 2014 to June 2015. So if your song is played today, as in now, in terms of SEMRO's distribution or SEMRO's computation, only after the radio station or the TV station has submitted cue sheets or program returns, or you have submitted our live performances to SEMRO, then we are able to say, okay, fine, says the apata. As I've said earlier on, the music user will pay in advance. We keep the money and then we distribute. Does that make sense? Music user pays the money. We collect, we go back to the radio station, whoever that uses the music, we get the information used, and then we pay it out. So that's basically how that works. Many a times, you find a lot of people in the music industry wearing different caps, as my brother said earlier on. You find that you are a composer, you are an author, you are a publisher, you are a producer, you are a record label owner, you manage artists, you record artists, etc., etc. Now, when at SEMRO, what we normally do is, when you come to SEMRO, we'll ask you those specific questions, which hat do you wear? Are you the composer, are you the author, or are you the publisher? Those are the three questions you're going to ask, and then you will notify your songs. Now you get to a person but I've applied for membership for 2010. I'm going to be member of SEMRO. There's normally various ways of why that happens. One of them is that you apply for membership, you completed the application form PEL. Yes, you have applied, but you haven't given SEMRO the mandate to go and collect your license fees. So we are unable to elect you to membership because as an IOLEO deed of assignment. Thirdly, you haven't notified your songs to SEMRO to say, or you find that you were in the process of recording and there's nothing wrong. Actually, we encourage you to come and notify your songs to SEMRO whilst you now know there's copyright within the song. The song doesn't have to be completed for you to apply for membership. You can always apply for membership even if you have one song. But for you to be elected to membership, your song needs to be exploited. And when I say exploited, I don't mean somebody who tati the white chopper, why Zara somewhere else, and then when you say somebody, but Victor Ute, my song has been exploited. Now, no, that's not what I mean. What I mean, when I say exploited, I mean it has been used. You've been credited for that. If you have performed it live, for example, and somebody else might have performed your song, whereas we're not the composer, you're not the artist as well. As long as your song has been played in a platform where a license fee was obtained, processed, and paid, then there will be royalties credited to you, then you'll be able to be elected to membership. There's board of directors which sit 4 times a year. When the board sits, we give them names of people that we think they're eligible for membership. Those people, the board will approve or disapprove for whatever reason. But what you've decided to, even though the board will still sit 4 times a year, Sibonile ukuthi between February, March, April, May, and June, there's people ukuthi they are eligible to become members of SEMBA. But now they get disadvantaged because we are waiting for the board to actually sit down and approve the applications. What we've decided to do is, yes, of course, with the permission of the board, we elect members in that period, even though the board hasn't signed them off yet. What we do is the executive of SEMBA, they will sign off on the membership as long as all the nitty-gritties have been met. Sign off the membership, then you become a member, and then we start paying you almost, and I say almost, depending on whether we've got all the relevant information for us to pay out. All your royalties is from 100 rands upwards. Because if it's 100 rands less, we can elect you to membership, but we will hold on to the money until it gets to 100 rands, and that is purely for administration purposes. If you're gonna deposit 1 cent into your account, the bank is gonna charge us, the bank is gonna charge you. You'll never see that 1 cent. But at least if we deposit 100 rands, and then at least if those bank charges, then you'll be able to still access some of those royalties for some of those funds. Now, what person would normally ask you to say, okay, ntatili mali yam, leya patara ukagasi FM, nahlala nayo imali. What happens to the interest? Because somebody's an NPC, not supposed to be making profit. Now, how we know, how we resolve that problem is, each and every interest we made from our royalties that we paid to SEMB, what we normally do firstly, we will take our administration fee from the interest. Not from the royalties paid, but from the interest. We'll take our administration fee. Then whatever balance is left, we will pay back to the members by a form of what you call NRR, non-royalty revenue. That is the money that you normally pay on December and and others, all some members will tell you. It has names. Abanyabiza, Impumpu, Malie Christmas, Braipeki, Malie Tolo. You know, all these things, then it's fine. We don't have a problem with all of those names. But what we're saying is, because we're not supposed to hold on to that money, and we already made interest from that, we have to give it back to you. And that's how, number one, we give it back to you. Secondly, when you become a member of SEMBA, automatically, you are covered with a funeral cover of 20,000 rands. You as the member, and if you have a spouse, legal spouse, I don't know, legal spouse, then automatically he or she is also covered. And all your children from the age of 21 going all the way down to stillborn, they are covered. And when you are not paying any money for that, you are not contributing towards that, SEMBA is contributing towards that. Secondly, we've got what we call a SRAF, a SEMBA Retirement Annuity Fund. So if you become a member of SEMBA, as long as you are 54 years old and down, then you qualify for a retirement annuity fund. Also, SEMBA contributes to that fund, and then you don't contribute. So if you reach the age of 55, you are eligible to retire from the fund. But if you still feel within, no, I'm still strong enough, this keep in us shy, I can still get on stage and perform and do what you need to do, then you can prolong it up to the age of 65. But when you get to 65, and if God has, you know, prevailed you to shy until 65, I normally say, umuntu ugaganga, I normally have sins. Okay, anyway, yeah, so when you reach the age of 65, then automatically, if you want to retire, we'll call you, send an email, make sure that you get the application form, you retire, then you get your money. And God bless you if you live up to 65. Because Tim Abanya, I come. Ah! I'm going to go to the house. I'm going to go to the house. Okay. There's different types of distributions that we have. I've already spoken about radio. We've got what we call a general. General is if your music, someone else performed your music at a licensed venue, or your music was exploited somewhere else within SEMRO's territory, and then you are the composer and then you can prove that, or your music was used, as I've said, to my restaurants or taverns, etc. Then that's what we call a general distribution. We normally fuse the radio and general, but now we've separated them, but we pay them almost the same time. We'll pay the radio first and then we'll pay the general. Then we have TV distribution, where if you have written either the opening theme for any program that plays on radio, either you have a jingle that plays on radio, either your music is played on TV, if either it can be either played on MTV or it can be played on any other music channel, then we pay for that. If your music has been used on a film, and what's the film, we mean movies. Okay, besides Abantu Abahlala and Abahlala, when last have you guys been to a movie? Bioscope. I just exposed myself, but singing that anyway. So if your music, you wrote your music, CC, you went to the movies and your song was used in a movie, doesn't matter which movie, it can be local or international. If your music has been used in that movie, then we will pay whichever cinema that has played that music will come back to us with our cue sheets. We will be able to pay you, provided you are a member of SEMRO. If your music was performed outside SEMRO territory, and remember I said SEMRO stands for Southern African Music Rights Organization. So if your music was playing out of those territory, with meaning Botswana, Lesotho, etc. Let's say music was played in Germany, let's say music was played in Australia or wherever outside SEMRO borders, then we will pay you. How that works is we have reciprocal agreements with our sister societies all over the world. And the nice part about it now is Africa is now getting itself organized. We are now having a society in Botswana. We are now having a society in Nigeria. We are about to have a society in Lesotho. And we are also mobilizing African countries to have their own societies so that we can work and then it becomes easier. If your music has played in Nigeria, you know, we don't have to contact or try and fish who's in Nigeria, who can we talk to, or Botswana, who can we play. No. We know that we have a society in Botswana. The agreement is simple. My client's music gets played in your territory. You make sure the license is paid. You make sure that you get the relevant documentation. Then you make sure that you provide us with information and those royalties. And then we will pay them out in terms of foreign royalties. I've mentioned a little bit. This is the major distribution that takes place within a space of 12 months, which is July to December of each and every year. If it happens within, your music was played on radio for the period I've mentioned, December 2015, 2016, then you are not paid and you are a member of SEMRO. Then what we'll normally do is we will pay you what we call post distribution, which takes place every month. And those post distributions are also a part of them, is what we call the undocked royalties. Okay, man, thank you.